Okay, so what do you do by the side of the boat when the great big muskie hits with very little line out? Real common question, great question, and there's several different ways to go about it. Now, a lot of people say disengage the reel as you come into your figure eight so that you're able to let line out, right? It's real important with muskie to get a good hook set because they got a real bony head, obviously, so you don't want any slippage on the hook set, but immediately thereafter, you're probably gonna wanna be able to let some line go out. Not always, sometimes the fish just sits there and bulldogs, but sometimes they'll take off on a run right away if you have a strike. And it doesn't even necessarily have to be at the figure eight. Could be the fish just hit 5 feet from the boat and you've got very little line out. But anyway, going into the figure eight, what do? Some people like to disengage that spool so you're ready. So they're coming up into it right away. They're pushing their button. They got the thumb on the spool, right? And they're holding that real tight. In case that fish hits right now, they're setting the hook. And then they can let their thumb slip and let line out if they want to. I personally kind of got in the habit of just leaving everything the way it is. And I set the hook with my super tight drag, and I'll do one or two things. I'll either disengage that reel immediately after the fish hits, or if I feel like I've got time and I'm able to gauge all of this, because again, generally they'll just sit there and bulldog, I'll reach over and pull my drag back a quarter of a turn. Generally, a quarter of a turn on a good muskie reel is gonna do what you need to do, get you where you wanna be. That fish is gonna be able to take a little line out, right? So you can do it either one of those ways, but you need to be prepared. The one thing that a lot of people don't realize, and this is why you got to think about this kind of stuff and practice before, is that if you leave the reel engaged and you get that big fish to hit and you're really excited and you want to, rather than loosening the drag, you want to go that disengaging the spool route, understand that you won't be able to just push the button while there's a tremendous amount of load on this reel, okay? It's going to be locked up on you. So you have to, if you're going to go that route, remember that your thumb will actually have to pull back towards you on the spool before you're going to be able to disengage that reel when you've got a big heavy fish pulling on there. So keep all of that in mind. And then very simply, I tell people the other thing, if you really want to catch the fish, try and keep that fish down. It's real neat to see them jump. It's cool to see them thrash and with their head out of the water. But if you really want to catch the fish, you don't want to see that. So if you do get lucky enough to hook that great big fish by both sides, you're ready to let them have some line. But the other thing you want to do is plunge that rod down. And literally, while you're fighting that fish, force that fish's head down. Always keep a bend in the rod. But you want to be literally pulling that fish down all the time. You don't want to see that facing you and coming out of the water. Most fish are able to actually steer around with the rod, even if you need to let them take a little line. But the bottom line is your odds of catching the fish are at least 50% better if you keep their head under the water.